Thank you for inviting me here. This is always a pleasure to be at the Universitat La Laguna. In the framework of a CBCon project, I'm one of the experts from outside. Living in Brussels, I have a background in 15 years in academia and 17 years in industry. So we help the university to translate research and knowledge and bring it to industry and to society. 2020 is a large European program for European research and development. And Europe would like to do exactly what I said, use the European knowledge, and there's a lot of knowledge in European universities, to make it useful for society and for industry. So the European Commission has designed a program where they focus on society challenges like health, poverty, renewable energies, and to make sure that links of universities and industries work towards a common goal. Most of the programs in Horizon 2020, as I said, focus on health, on society challenges like healthy aging, how do you survive with cancer, how do you make better therapies, how do you make better biology for better plants, grow better and safe food. So those challenges are not to be solved by a scientist in a university alone. So what Europe would like to see is that the university scientists actually find partners as pieces of a puzzle, work in a team, together with industry and solve those problems in consortia. And this may be new to some of the scientists at the university, to work in consortium where you have a scientific role next to industry partners who bring products to the market. The European Commission would like to reinforce, strengthen the link between research and innovation. In previous programs, it was there, but not very visible. So now the European Commission wants really to translate knowledge through society and innovative solutions bringing to people in society. That means that if you develop consortia, you need a long-term strategy. As an academic center, you can do the first steps of a long-term strategy and link it all the way to the market. Not that you have to bring the products to the market, that's the task of your industry partner. But you have to match your strategy with the industry partners and communicate about it. Tell the stakeholders, the patients, the users about your knowledge and become more visible. And I think that is a fantastic opportunity for the university to use these European programs to collaborate internationally and become visible internationally and recognized. I gave just a presentation a little bit on tips on how to do that. First of all, need a strategy from what your knowledge can contribute to these society problems. And then find partners who can do the missing pieces of work. Industry partners, other academic partners who have different essays, different methodologies, different collections and libraries, or different knowledge about solutions. Like you have a scientist working on a new drug, you need to collaborate with the university where they have the patients, and with an industry who then makes the drug and makes it available. So linking that in a common strategy beyond the scientific work you do in the lab is one thing. Don't be shy about your assets and your knowledge that you have in-house. People out there in Europe don't even know that you have very valuable things, so communicate about it openly. And third, choose your partners carefully and choose the best partners in your field. Don't work with unknown partners, but try to lift your visibility by working with the biggest institutes in Europe, and then they can do some of the visibility and marketing for you. And fourth, be careful with the management aspects of the research. The management of the project, the times, the budgets, but also about the communication. What information do you need to keep confidential, not to unnerve your industry partner? And what information should be given out to other stakeholders, like the government, telling them that you are finding a solution that would be very, very important for the environment. So those things, don't be shy, be open, and work with the best partners in Europe. And that way you can start from very small projects, and next time you can prepare for much larger research projects, and your group can grow. Most scientists, they start with their work plan. They start with, I can do this, and another partner can do that, and they start from the scientific level. But good practice is first think from how can your science be useful in a larger objective, like curing a next disease for cancer patients. And then you select your tasks, what you can do, what your partners can do, and you try to build a project that has a potential to lead to further projects. then the evaluators in Europe, like they do for the Spanish agency, they will not look only at the scientific methodology. Are you taking the right approach? And is it the best test that you're developing? But they equally look at your impact. Is it important what you do? Do you develop something for just 20 patients in Poland, or do you develop for all cancer patients in Europe? And the third element, and that is the classical thing we discussed today in the presentations, is about the management aspects. How do you manage a project? How do you manage communication? How do you manage intellectual property? And that management and reporting is important, equally important next to the science, to make it a success. Now, the biggest suggestion I gave today is that an institute or a university could help the scientist by installing a research management office and a technology transfer office as a service to the scientist, so that the scientist can focus back on the science and help the scientist to find funding calls, find the way to navigate in the programs, and help to find partners abroad. And that's the dividing of roles. Scientists can focus back on doing the science in the lab, and the institute as an internal service can help to become more efficient as an institute.